Thank you. Thank you, my Lord. We just have to say thank you. Thank you, my Lord. Men in moon suits shovel corpses like the rubble. Bodies piled high in the back of pickups. Crowds across the street keep their distance. The sound of mourning screams are constant. People lie like dogs in the street. Their cries for help go unanswered. The world's afraid to come too close. In my rubber boots, on bended knee, the stench of vomit was mixed with feces. His soft baby cheeks against the dirt and dust. There was no ma for his hand to cup, alone in a bath of his own blood. I asked him his name, he could barely speak. Softly he tells me, I'm Charlie. He reaches for my hand, but I had to back up. As much as I wanted to hold him, this is an enemy that preys on love. If only my songs could hold his face, encircle him in warm embrace, the soft notes down his back they'd trace. Thank you, my Lord, we just have to say thank you, my Lord. Death tolls are rising like the tides. Tension is more tangible than touch. Bodies are being buried in mass graves while experts sip coffees and lattes, have cocktail parties and all-day debates on the best strategies and philosophies that determine the fate of these communities that they have never even freaking been to. So I beg you now, please help. Boots on the ground is what we need. We're out of water and PPEs. No bleach, no bed, and no IVs. Wages for employees, hospitals transmitting more disease, a country that lacks complete capacity. And there was Esther, hairnet on her head, in a woman's oversized flower dress. All the people around her sang with their arms stretched to the sky in praise. They were thanking God for their lives. This was a survivor's party, except there was nothing about Esther that was happy. She survived Ebola, but when she woke up from a coma, she learned that her entire family didn't. She was about to be released, except for there was nobody there to get her. In a country without adoption and with no foster care system, where will she go? And the world leaves her in the hands of the Liberian government that is vividly broken as you freak out about an outbreak in America that will never freaking happen. For God's sake, get a grip. Sarah was stronger than any human being I've ever known. I gave her two teddy bears and a telephone. We stood outside of the Ebola treatment unit. I looked into her eyes and I told her that she was gonna be okay. I lied. She walked down that hall and she never came back out. Are you sure? She seemed so strong. Sometimes they just drop dead. I couldn't get the words out. I just looked at her mother. My lips quivered. I dropped my head and sobbed. She got the message and collapsed. She flung her arms to the air and she shook. No place for her to say her last goodbyes. No I love you, baby. No tears to wipe. No hand to hold throughout the night. Sarah's life is gone. The world doesn't stop. The debates go on. The blame goes on. The fight for attention. The corruption. It goes on. Sarah's life is gone. She is gone. We let this go on, and now her precious life has slipped gone. I'm not okay, and nobody gets it. No one. These images won't go away. They stain my mind and keep me awake. Sometimes I think about that little girl just dead on a bench. Or Sarah's mother's face. I'd sometimes weep thinking about what a lonely, inhumane death small Charlie had. It's sad and it's dark, but then I think about the survivors, like Esther. Everything that she has lost, but she has life, and I have life, and you have life, and we must use it to the max. This will never be okay until we make sure it never happens again.